Welcome once again to my channel English Made Easy with Mandeep. And today I have come up with the most important questions from the chapter Deep Water, that is chapter 3 from Flamingo textbook. So here, as you can see on the screen, the theme of the chapter has been mentioned here. The theme is to overcome fear with hard work and determination. I have also mentioned, as you can see, there are 9 points that I have mentioned here. You can see it on the screen. There are 9 points here, which are all related to your text, the chapter, the story, what it is all about. You can use these, you can say sayings or good quotes or good phrases in your answers, so that you can make your answers look more ornamental. You can beautify your answers using all these quotes so that you get good marks in your exams. You can see, only when we are no longer afraid do we begin to live. He who has overcome his fears will truly be free. The only thing we have to fear is fear itself. See, there is a question also, very important question related to this, the third one. The only thing we have to fear is fear itself. It was said by Roosevelt. And so through this question, a question can be asked, either a value-based question or a short question can also be asked, that what do you understand by this statement of Roosevelt? Or it can also be asked, what did Douglas come to know about this statement? What did this statement mean to Douglas, right? So these kind of questions can come. Then the fourth one is, the fear we don't face become our limits. So the fears we don't face become our limits, because when we have not faced those fears, we don't know what kind of fear that is going to be. Okay, whether that fear will be long lasting, like the one that William had. William had a phobia. He could not go inside the swimming pool. Whenever he would see water, he would there was an aversion in him. So that's why it has been truly said that the fears we don't face become our limits. So you can use all these phrases in your answers to beautify your answers. Fear is temporary, very true. As you can see from the theme itself, the theme also says that the fear is temporary. It is not going to last long until and unless we don't fight that fear, right? Fear is a creation of your mind. Very true. It doesn't exist independently. So what is fear? Fear doesn't exist independently. It is what you think in your mind. This is what Douglas thought in his mind, that I will not be able to swim. I will not be able to become a good swimmer. Earlier, when he was thrown into the swimming pool, he was so restless. He felt so bad. And he was shivering and he was quivering and he didn't know as to what to do, what not to do. And he had made up his mind that now again I'm never going to set my foot in the pool. But then something happened. He changed his mindset and then he turned out to be a very good swimmer. Terror seized me. Then these are the phrases which I have taken out from your textbook. Terror seized me is a phrase which has been used in your textbook. Then hurt in my mouth means he was so very fearful of swimming that it was as if his heart was pounding and it would come to his mouth. Nearly death, it means the experiences which are very near to death is called as hurt in my mouth. Conquered my fear of water. Terror knows no understanding. Shook and trembled with fright. So these are the phrases and the sentences which are there in your book. Because whenever we are writing the answers, it is very important for us to hold those keywords also, to have those keywords in the answer. If we will not have those keywords in the answer, then there are chances that we might not score good marks. So it's better that you people have these keywords with you and use them in your answers. So I have taken out 5 most important questions which deal with each and everything which is there in the whole of the chapter, that is the deep water. So as you can see on the screen, the very first question, which two incidents in Douglas's early life made him scared of water? So there were two incidents. So you are going to tell both the incidents. One is of California when he was a very small child, maybe a 3 year or a 4 year old child. And that was the time when he went along with his father, and then he was thrown away by the waves. So because of that, there was a fear in his mind. And the second time when at the YMCA pool, he was again pushed into deep water, deeper side of the pool. So these were the two incidents that had made him very fearful of going inside water. So now if you want, you can note down the points which are there, so that you it is easy for you to jot down the answers and all. See the points which are, they are like when he was 3 or 4 years old, that is very important part of this. Then where, that is beach in California, is again a very important thing. You will have to write this beach in California, because these are the keywords which you need to have. Like YMCA pool is a keyword of this chapter, of this question. Then there, a big bully of a boy who tossed him into deep water, these are also few phrases which you need to put in this answer, because these are the keywords which are the, which is the basic requirement of this particular answer. So do not forget to not to put it, do put it. Okay, now we have the next question. What did Douglas feel and do when he was pushed into the swimming pool? Or what were the series of emotions and fears that Douglas experienced when he was thrown into the pool? Or what sort of terror seized Douglas? Seized means stopped Douglas as he went down the water with a yellow glow. How could he feel that he was still alive? So any question, if it comes in your exams, you will be writing the same answer which I have written here. Like when Douglas was thrown into the pool, he did not lose heart, because he was planning in his mind as to when I will go down, I will touch the ground, okay, the bottom of the pool, and then I'll push up so that I can come up to the level of the pool, and then I might get saved. I'll paddle and I'll come up and I might get saved. So this strategy was going on in his mind. But unfortunately, did it happen? No, it could not happen. His strategy did not work, because he was so fearful. Terror had gripped the child so much that he could not move his feet, he could not paddle, he couldn't do anything. So twice he made an attempt to come up, but both the times he was unsuccessful. So this is what you have to write. See, now in the question is demanding the emotions and the fears. So you will have to write those particular words which will show the emotions and the fears of that boy. So they will come out through that he did not lose heart. This is also one of the emotions. Then we come to the strategy did not work. Terror gripped him. This is a very good phrase which you can use in this answer. Then lungs were ready to burst. Again, a good phrase. It has been taken from the book itself. He was breathless, and instead of air, he sucked water. So if you will put these words, you will fetch good marks. Now again we come to question number 3. Why was Douglas determined to get over his fear of water? So why was he determined that I have to get over the fear of the water? Because there was a very deep imprint on his mind, on his heart, that both the incidents, that is of California Beach as well as the YMCA pool, they were imprinted like anything in his mind and his heart, then he was unable to come out of that fear. So in order to remove that fear, in order to come out of that fear of water, okay, so he just wanted to learn swimming. Okay, and secondly, whenever his friends or the other people, they would go and enjoy and near the beach, or go for canoeing, or go for any kind of water sports and all, so he would not go. Why? Because he was fearful of everything. So in order to enjoy, as I have written, he had phobia of water, which hampered all his joy. Hampered means stopped all his joy, and he could not enjoy water sports like canoeing, like fishing, like boating, like swimming. So he did not want to live with this handicap. So he was a handicap. But because when you know that you can learn something and you are not learning it, that means you have made that handicap overpower you, right? So he did not want that thing to happen. So he was determined that no, definitely I'm going to overcome this fear of water. Now we come to question number 4. It's a long question. You can say it's a question of HOTS, high order thinking skills, or you can say long answer type question. Douglas fully realized the truth of Roosevelt's statement, all we have to fear is fear itself. How did this realization help him brush aside his fear and become an expert swimmer? Okay, now Douglas had experienced both the sensation of dying and the terror that the fear of death can cause. So Douglas was very, very fearful. Why? Because it was a near to death experience that he had faced at YMCA pool. Okay, so these are the few very important you can say phrases that you can use: strong will, hard determination, courage and toil, as well as honest labor. So these were the things, these were the qualities of this boy which helped him overcome this fear of water. Okay, he won over all these terrors, he won over all the fears because of his strong will. He was so determined, he was so courageous and hardworking and laborious that he gave his 100% in order to win over that fear. The will to live brushed aside all his fears. Now he just wanted to live. Live means enjoy each and every part of his life. Enjoy water sports. And if we can control our mind, if we can tell our mind, keep on knocking at our mind that no, this is just a fear and we can overcome it, then definitely we'll be able to overcome that. So this realization makes Douglas resolve to learn swimming. So he thought that no, I am definitely going to learn swimming, and he learns it. He engages an instructor, and the instructor piece by piece. See, this particular phrase is there in that in the book of yours. This the instructor piece by piece means from very scratch he started teaching him, and he kept on teaching him till he made him a good swimmer. Built Douglas into a swimmer. This is again a phrase. Built Douglas into a swimmer. So he changed him into a good swimmer. However, his first step was to drive away Douglas's fear of water. So the most important thing is to take away the fear of, to drive away what? The fear of water from his mind. Before training him into swimming techniques, when Douglas tried and swam the length of the pool up and down, small traces of his old terror of water would return. So he went to Lake Wentworth, dived at Triggs Island, and swam 2 miles across the lake to Stamp Act Island. Now, when you'll go through your book once again, you will find out that these are the few places and all which you will have to mention in your answer, because if you will mention these places, you can learn them. See, there are just two things. One is Triggs Island, and the other thing is Stamp Act Island. If you will mention these words, these particular places in your answer, that will show that yes, you have gone through the chapter very carefully and you will get really good marks. So finally, he was certain that he had conquered his fear of water. And in this way, he realized that now I have conquered my fear of water. I am no more fearful of water. So this is, now we have the last question on the screen as you can see. How did Douglas develop an aversion to water? Means what all things happened in his life that he started feeling fearful of water. So this question is also there in 25 to 30 words also this question can be asked, and it can be a lengthy question also, or you can say it can come like this also. So both the answers are going to be same. Inverted commas begin. There was terror in my heart at the overpowering force of the waves. When did Douglas start fearing water? First thing. Which experience had further strengthened its hold on his mind and personality? Okay, so first thing is, when did it actually start? It start at the beach of California. And the second thing is, which experience further strengthened it when he went to YMCA pool and he was tossed into the deeper side of the swimming pool by a robust boy. So that was the time when it grew, it strengthened like anything, and it had such a drastic hold over his mind and his body that he could not just come out of that, right? It was so very deep rooted in him. Like you can say, the first thing is, when he went to beach in California, okay, the waves knocked him, that is important, and swept him. So he was buried in water. He was frightened, but his father was laughing. Perhaps this was the moment his fear of water took root inside his mind. Fear of water took root inside his mind. This is very important. So do mention this in your answer. Then again, what happened? Then he went to YMCA pool. Here an incident took place, as I have just mentioned. There was a, and which led to big fear, which increased the fear many folds in his mind. So there was an 18 year old boy. So you have to tell this. There was a big boy who was 18 years of age. He threw him into the deep end of the pool. Okay. And it was like a nightmarish experience for William Douglas. Okay. So he tried very hard and applied all his knowledge, but could not come to the surface. He tried twice, thrice, but then it was hopeless. What you can say, it was a hopeless try. He could not, his mind was saying something else and his body was doing some other kind of action because he was so fearful. The fear had a big hold over that boy. Okay, so that's why he could not come out of that water. Somehow he was saved. Thus, after his fearful incident, his fear of water got implanted in his heart. It was implanted, it was deeply rooted in his heart. So these were the most important questions that I have discussed with you. Okay, do go through these questions, because I have taken out these questions from inside the chapter, and these are the most important questions, and all the questions that will be framed will be based only on these particular 5 questions. I hope you have enjoyed watching this video. And do not forget to share it with your friends. And if your friends have not subscribed it, then